Hey everyone, it's Justin again. Now that we understand functions and function notation, in this video, we're going to put them in context by using functions alongside word problems. Before we can put functions into context, we need to understand how inputs and outputs work in real-life scenarios. The output is the dependent variable because its value depends on what happened to the other variable. The input will be called the independent variable because it doesn't depend on any other variables. Take, for example, measurements in temperature. When measuring temperature, the temperature can depend on what time of day it is, what time of year it is, where on earth you're measuring from, or many other factors. So temperature is the dependent variable, while all the factors that it depends on are independent. They aren't changed by anything else unless we intentionally wait until a later time or move to a different place. With that out of the way, let's look at some examples. An amusement park measures how many visitors it has several hours after opening for the day and models that data using a function, Q of R. What does the statement Q of 4 mean? The most important part here is knowing what the independent and dependent variables are. So out of the time after opening and the amount of visitors, which depends on the other? The time won't magically change based on how many visitors there are, but as the day goes on, some people will enter and others will leave. So the time of day is independent and the amount of visitors will be dependent on the time. Remember, independent and dependent variables have other names, input and output. The input is always independent, and output is always dependent. So then, according to the function notation Q of R, what variable is the time, and which is the number of visitors? Well, since R is the input, that will be the independent variable, or the time of day. And the output, function Q, is the number of visitors. Now we can answer the question because we can see in Q of 4 that R, or the time after the amusement park opens, is 4 hours. So this statement reads the number of visitors at the amusement park 4 hours after it opens. I mentioned this on the previous example, but it's important to remember that the output depends on the input. So the output is always dependent and the input is always independent. In function notation, it's super easy to recognize which variable is which. The variable inside the function is the independent input, while the function name that appears on the outside is the dependent output. Let's take a look at another example. The average weight of kittens in ounces, some number of months after being born, can be represented by the function C of D. What does the statement C of D equals 6 tell us? In order to read that function, we're going to first have to identify which variable is dependent and which is independent. We know from C of D that C is the function output and D is the input. The output is always dependent and the input is always independent. So out of the two measurements here, age of the kittens and weight of the kittens, which depends on the other? The kitten's weight depends upon its age. Now that we know which variable is which, we can decipher C of D equals 6. This tells us that when the kitten is D months old, it will weigh 6 ounces. The D months old part is because we don't actually know what the value of D is, just that the weight associated with that age will be 6 ounces. One more example. This time, we'll decipher a complete statement in function notation. A science test is graded on a scale of 0 to 100, and the number of students that made that grade is represented by the function n of s. What does the statement n of 84 equals 6 tell us? At this point, we could skip a few steps when looking at the function n of s. This tells us that n depends on s. In the context of the problem, which depends on the other? The grades on the test? Or how many students made a certain grade? If we wanted to count how many students made a certain grade, we'd have to decide what grade to look for first. In other words, the number of students who made a certain grade depends on which grade we chose to look at. Counting the number of students that made 100 is different from counting the amount that made a 70. So the dependent variable n is the number of students, and the independent variable s is the grade those students made on the test. Now we're ready to understand what n of 84 equals 6 means. The s here is 84, so that's the grade we're focused on. N of 84 means the number of students that made an 84, and that number is 6. So altogether, this statement says the number of students who made an 84 was 6. Or to put it in a more natural way, 6 students got an 84 on the test. A lot of data in the real world is expressed as functions, but it's easy to understand as long as you recognize the difference between the dependent and independent variables. Practice using the game on our website, and you'll be a pro in no time.